Armed with their scimitars and a smug look on their face, these warriors of excessive narcissism are not to be taken lightly, or it may just cost you your head. In this video, we'll be painting the Lord of Hubris quickly with only 10 paints, so he's ready to cut his foes into ribbons. First, we'll undercoat the model, and for this we've used Wraithbone. This is perfect for the warmer and vibrant colours we'll be using on this model. It's also a good idea to have Wraithbone base paint to hand as well, just to tidy up any mistakes we make along the way. Those 10 paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. Remember that these are our recommendations and you can always paint your models however you like. If you are new to painting or want to know the paints and the techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. First, we'll start by painting the skin with Night Questor Flesh, and we'll be using our small base brush for this. We'll need to apply a couple of thin layers of this colour to build up the coverage, as this is a layer paint rather than a base paint. Don't worry if you get any of the paint onto any areas like the armour or the shields, as we'll be painting over these later. Do be careful around other areas though, as we might need these for our contrast colours later on. Night Questor Flesh is perfect for the warm, bronzed skin of this vain champion. Next, we'll apply Sigvel Burgundy to the cloth sash and the tassels on his headdress. We'll use a small layer brush to apply this contrast paint, so we can have more control of how much we are putting onto the model. We want a good amount to be on there, so it colours the area and sits nicely into those recesses, but we don't want so much that it starts to run into the other colours. If you're finding it's pooling too heavily, take a clean brush and you can soak it away from that area. If it is stained in the unwanted area, leave it to fully dry, then reapply Wraithbone from the pot to tidy over. Now that's dry, we'll apply Incubi Darkness to the shield, gemstones and to the bottle. We'll use our small base brush as it's a little bit bigger, so it'll help us get some really clean brush strokes over that shield. You don't have to be super neat when applying this in multiple layers, just make sure that they are smooth layers. The only area that you have to be wary about is his arm, but you can always touch up any little mistakes with Night Questor Flesh. The shield can be messy too, as we'll be covering that up with some metallic colours next. The green tone of Incubi Darkness is a great contrasting colour to the vibrant purple of Sigvel Burgundy, making the model look more balanced, not too bright or dark. With those first few paints fully dry, we'll move on to a couple of metallic paints next. First, we'll apply Skullcrusher Brass to the armour, the shield edging and the hilt of the Vainglory sword. Now we're painting next to our first three colours, we'll take our time and we'll be using a small layer brush, just so we don't smudge any metallics onto those colours, especially those contrast colours. But you can tidy up afterwards if you make any small mistakes. This colour covers quite well, but you might find that you need a second thin coat to get that solid shiny colour. Next, we'll use Iron Hand Steel for the sword blade, the silver studs on the cloth and the Slaanesh icons found on the shield and on the end of the belt. Just like with Skullcrusher Brass, we want to be careful of some of those areas that we painted around. Once you've applied your last coat of this paint, we'll go and change our paint water, so we don't get any metallic flakes into our next paints. Now we'll add some Black Legion to the model in two ways. First, we'll use it straight out of the pot for the black leather gloves and studded trousers. Just make sure that we don't get any on the skin or other details we just painted. As we want the raised areas of the cloth to be lighter, we don't want to go too heavy with the contrast here, but you could always add a second layer to the recesses if they aren't dark enough. Then we'll take one part Black Legion and then two parts water to thin it down slightly for the silver and Incubi Darkness recesses. Just make sure you don't apply too much or too heavily. Just remember that you can always soak up any excess contrast paint if it's pooling too much with a dry brush. Now that our Lord of Hubris has some colours on him, we can start adding some shading, just to give some shadows to those bright colours. We'll start by recess shading the skin with Targhor Rage Shade. We'll do this with a small layer brush, so we can get into those muscled recesses really easily, without getting too much on the raised areas. And you can also add some more Targhor Rage Shade if you want some recesses to be really dark. Next up is Druki Violet for the gold details and tassel ends. For the gold, we'll thin down one part Druki Violet to two parts water. Then we'll apply it all over the gold, but focusing mostly into those recesses. As it starts to settle down, you can remove some from the most raised areas with your brush. This just avoids the gold being too purple, as we want it to lightly stain it. After that's dry, we can use pure Druki Violet on the tassels. We'll apply it towards the bottom to give the material a darker hue. Now that the shades are dry, we can add a cheeky highlight to both the silver and the gold details with Stormhost Silver. As we'll be just highlighting the major raised areas and edges, we won't need too much on our brush. We just want to accentuate the brightness of those metals. Using such a light silver on both metallics will give more of a uniform finish on the model. When you have finished applying the silver, we just need to change our paint water one more time. Finally, we'll thin down some basilicon and grey for the stone head on the base he is standing on. Thin down one part contrast to two parts water for the first coat. Once that first coat is dry, we can see how dark or light some of the recesses are, especially around those eye sockets. Then we can add a bit more to the mix if those recesses to get them a little bit darker. You can even dry brush the stone in the same colours that you'll be dry brushing your texture paint with. This will help to tie in the stone to the base really well, even if the texture is different, like stone, mud or sand. And there we are, your Lord of Hubris is finished and ready to strut into the fray, slaying with ease as he goes. You can see that our model is based on astrogranite, but you can base it in any colour that you want. If you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video all about it. For more tutorials, tips and techniques, head to citadelcolour.com, or you can also head into a store where our friendly staff can help you out. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye!